Hey, it's Andy here. Welcome along to this lesson where I'm going to be teaching you how to play Wonderwall by Oasis. Now, this is a special beginner's lesson. I noticed there is a lot of videos teaching this song around the place, and this has quite a challenging strumming pattern. If you don't have a natural feel for picking up rhythms, the rhythm in the original song is quite difficult, and I noticed there's a lot of tutorials that are teaching all this down, up, down, 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 up, down, down, up, down, up. It sounds like Morse code. And if I was a beginner, I know that would be extremely difficult to pick up. So this is the easy lesson for picking it up. Here is the rhythm for the original. So there is the original rhythm. We're going to simplify that down a bit. Tricky thing about this is it's a two bar pattern. We're going to make a single bar pattern and use the first bar and then repeat that over, which is a lot easier to learn. So the rhythm we're going to do is this. Cool. So, you can get little variations on that to make it a little more interesting as well. But you'll notice, that sounds pretty close to the original, doesn't it? Once you can get that going, it's a lot easier to step up to the full version. So, our chords in this song are, we've got an E minor with this little extended 3rd and 4th finger down on the 3rd fret B string, 3rd fret E string. And that's going to happen for all our shapes. It's kind of like the bottom of a G chord on the bottom of all your other chords. So here's our E minor. Then we get G, then we get D with that little extension on the bottom, and then we get an A with that extension on the bottom. E, G, D, A. The other chord shape that we have in there as well is a C9, which is like a G chord, except we're going to move our first and second fingers down a string. We're going to play from that A string. So, they're pretty much all the chords that we have in the song, pretty straight ahead apart from one tiny little bit which I'll show you after. So, there's our chords. Let's have a look at this strumming pattern. The real key thing to get going here that you hear a lot of people say is keep your hand moving, but that's not a lot of information there. What does that really mean with keeping your hand moving? I'm going to elaborate on that a little bit further, and I'm going to tell you, for each of your beats, you need to divide it up into four parts. We need to make it into quarters. So for each beat, 1, 2, 3, 4, your hand needs to be doing this. 1E and a, 2E and a, 3E and a, 4E and a, dividing it into quarters. Do that with me. It seems simple, but it's really key for getting your rhythm. Once you've got that going, you can then try out the rhythm, which is 1, 2, 3, E, and 4. Or you can say down, 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 up, down, up, down, down. When you get all those downs and ups, I think that tends to mess with a lot of people's heads. It certainly would mess with my head if I hadn't done a lot of strumming before. So I'm going to say that in both ways. Down, 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 up, down, up, down, down. Or 1, 2, 3, E, and 4. So there is our strumming pattern. Let's try that with that E chord. 1, 2, 3, E, and 4. Now, if we want to get our first change going, here we have our E minor to the G. The G is going to change on an upbeat, which again is another challenging factor in this rhythm. A lot of chord changes in easier songs are going to be only on the downstrokes. For this song, we have the changes on the upstrokes, and that's where a lot of people get caught out. So I'm going to show that slow. Down, 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 up, down. There we are, on the upstroke there. That's where our G changes. Down, 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 up, down, G. Again, D, G. Again, G. And then we do the same thing from our D to our A chords. So, D, on the upbeat there. You put all four together, you get G, D, A. Sweet. There is our verse section. Our next section is C to D, and then we stay on our E for a full bar. So we get C, C, D, E. The last time we get C, D, and here's our other chords that we didn't look at before. A lot of people write this out as having a descending bass line down here from our G going down 3rd fret, 2nd fret, etc. It doesn't sound quite right to my ear when I hear that, so I do it this way. It's the same thing, but I'm going to do this bass line running down an octave higher. So I do it like this. Just like the sound of that. So what we've got in there is a bass line running down G, F sharp, E, D. And here's how we're going to do it. We're going to take this little extension shape that we had. We're going to take our fourth finger off though. So we get open G, third fret on the B, open E. And then we're going to get this next bass note with our fourth finger on the fourth fret of the D string. And we're going to get those four strings. Then we're going to get second fret on the D with our first finger. And then open, nice and easy, from the D string. So we get open G, 4th fret on the D, 2nd fret on the D, and then open. All of those are pretty easy, apart from possibly just that 4th finger, getting that comfortable to jump over. All the others are a piece of cake, they're just one finger to set up there. So, leading into that, it'd sound like C, D, and then we get the A for bars. Then you're in the home straight. You've got the chorus, which is C, E, G, E. C, E, G, E. And again, it's the same transition as we did before. So, as you can see, a lot easier than trying to get the full version with lots of different transitions and heaps of different things going on in the strumming pattern to think about. Once you get this version, getting the full version is a lot easier. One little thing that you can get on top of this as well, and I've probably slipped it in here occasionally as well, you can get a tiny bit more strumming on the end of this bar, a little bit of an ander on the fourth beat. So here's what it sounds like. Ander. Ander. So you probably don't even notice the difference. It sounds pretty much the same to the ear. It's a tiny little variation that gives you just a little bit more filler in the bar. That is the first little thing that you can do to start to give this simpler version a little bit more variety to keep things interesting for yourself before you then move on to the full strumming pattern. So, we've got all of those bits in there. I'm going to give you your backing track to play through slow and your backing track to play through at full speed. Of course, you can check out the tablature for this lesson. We've got a bit of a chart there. It's actually a chart rather than tab because it's all chords that are going on there. And you can check that out at nailguitar.com. There's a quick link in there. Go through that and you'll be able to get those downloads of also the backing tracks as well. So you can practice it and you don't have to come back to this video again and again to play through with your backing tracks. Or for quick reference, you've got the sheet there. You can print it out. Makes things really easy. So, I hope you've enjoyed what we've got there so far. Obviously, I'm not doing it with a capo. You can throw your capo on there to get it like the original song. I just taught it without because obviously it's a lot easier that way. If you don't have a capo, you can't learn from a lesson that teaches with a capo. So there we go. Have fun with it and I'll catch you for another lesson soon.